higher. And a closer look at those higher crush numbers, the National Oilseed Processors Association saying in its monthly report that almost 184 million bushels were crushed. That's well above last month's 154 million bushels and higher than the trade was expecting. Clinton has more on what the market was looking for with this report in today's analysis.
Joe Baklavik with Standard Grain, our guest today. Joe, as we talk about really the supply and the demand usage of corn and soybeans this year, what are you seeing out there that could be a positive for us?
Well, we're finally going to see some positive demand news in regard to soybeans on Monday morning, in all likelihood. We're going to see the NOPA crush number for the month of October. We've talked at length, or I've talked at length, and I'm sure you have on the show, about the woes of the export program. And that represents about half of the demand base for every soybean grown in the U.S. Domestic crush, or the processor, that's the other half. And we're going to see a really, really strong crush number from NOPA reported on Monday for the month of October. And that's something that I expect to continue. Crush margins for the domestic processor are very, very good. They're the best in years. So I think that the U.S. soybean processor should be crushing beans near maximum capacity here for months to come. That would be my guess. And hopefully they can pick up at least some of the slack that's going to be left by the export program, which has struggled. And it's been a long time since we've seen any real positive demand news in regard to soybeans, but you're going to see it on Monday.
Great. And what about on the corn side of things with ethanol? Those profits seem to be pretty strong.
Yeah, the ethanol number in terms of weekly production was off a little bit this week, but we're still well ahead of last year. We're still ahead of 2019. We've been near record production levels, and that should continue too. You know, not only are we producing a lot of ethanol, but we're using it. Ethanol stocks remain, I think they're at their second lowest level seasonally in the last 5 years, which is a big positive. And you got big demand for gasoline, which means big demand for ethanol. It's really a big positive. It's helped to support not only corn futures, but the basis market as well.
Hey, as we look at these, both of these things going forward into 2022, do you think that gives us a little bit of a floor here?
Yeah, to some extent. Now, in corn, I would say yes, although you've got to remember that each ethanol plant in the U.S. ethanol industry has a limited capacity. We can't grind an unlimited amount of corn for ethanol. We only have so much capacity. And you can say the same thing about soybeans. But both of those factors, the fact that soybean crush margins are fantastic and ethanol production margins are fantastic, I mean, it's definitely a friendly factor that should be supportive well into next year, I'd imagine.
All right. Appreciate it as always. Thank you so much for being here, Joe. We'll be back with more Ag Day coming up.
For more information about Standard Grain and its services, call Joe at 312-462-4438.